I remember when I was a lad, times were hard and things were bad, but there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor people, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of blackland dirt. But we'd get together in a family circle singing loud. Daddy sang bass,
Mama sang tenor,
me and little brother would join right in there.
Singing seems to help a troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'll rejoin them in a song. I'm gonna join the family circle at the throne.
Good morning.
Saturday morning and beautiful North Olympic Peninsula. We're Brett and Amy, and we're realtors here in Port Angeles and Sequim, and we represent buyers and sellers. We love what we do, and we bring you every week a real estate update
of the homes that have sold this previous week. And we have 24 of them today.
Yeah. So. We got a bunch. So we're going to move right through. Quick reminder, we've got another milestone coming up with when we hit 600
subscribers,
yeah. And we have one of Logan's pouches. I don't know what you call this one.
Pickle pouch.
What?
Pickle pouch.
Pickle pouch. And you can keep a whole bunch of something in there, you know, if it's small, like your gold Krugerrands or American Eagles, time. Whatever. So, and how we do that?
It'll be a drawing.
It'll be a drawing, and we'll let you know. So, we're at 588 now.
That's what I saw.
So, if you've not pushed the subscribe and like button, do that. And so here we go. We'll get right into it. And
would you see what's wrong with the dogs? Thanks. Okay, we'll start in Port Angeles. This first house is on East 9th Street. We start from the least expensive to the most expensive, first in Port Angeles, then in Sequim. So this one was listed for $295,000, and it sold for $25,000 more. Not, you have your math wrong here.
Or yeah. NPA.
Yeah.
On original East price 449. Sold price 449.
Well, honey, excuse us.
Oh.
And it's not 75 down. It went up 25.
Oh. Okay. I did the math. Not a
I won't
strong,
say anymore.
Not a strong.
Two bedrooms, one bath, 12 days on the market, built in 1920 with 876 square feet on 0.16 of an acre and a neighborhood view.
Okay. Our next home that closed the last week is on C Street, that away from us. And sold at asking at $329,900. Three bedrooms, one bath, 10 days on the market, built in 1952. It has 1,404 square feet with 0.16 standard acre and with mountain view.
Okay. The next house is on East Keller, listed. That's a ball that might fly in front of us. $324,500, and that's what it sold for. One bedroom, two baths, interesting combination. 8 days on the market, built in 1992 with 1,482 square feet on 0.37 of an acre. So,
okay.
And neighborhood view. This one, let's see.
Checking my math.
Yes.
Okay, the next one is on Willow Lane. Originally priced for $379,000.
Oh, right. You're right.
Sold for $355,000, $24,000 less than asking. Two bedrooms, two baths, 100 days on the market, built in 2024, brand new, looks like. And it has 1,280 square feet with 0.26 of an acre and a neighborhood view.
Okay, the next house is on, the fifth house is on McCarver Street. Listed for $395,000, it sold for $375,000. Three bedrooms, two baths, 48 days on the market. Built in 1975 with 1,152 square feet on 0.24 of an acre and a mountain view.
All right. And now we move out to East 5th, which is that way. and sold at asking at $439,000. This home has three bedrooms, two baths, and 5 days on the market, built in 1967 with 1,872 square feet at 0.18 of an acre. Kind of a small lot with salt water and mountain view.
Did you turn your sound off?
So sure.
Beeping. And the next house in Port Angeles is on East 5th Street. I hear it going off. It has four bedrooms, two and a half baths, 14 days on the market, built in 1918 with 1,432 square feet, 0.16 of an acre, salt water, and mountain view.
Cool. Okay. this is on Mountain View Circle, and originally priced for $634,000.
Wow.
Sold for $450,000, a whopping
$184,000. Wow.
Less than asking. And three bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 53 days on the market, built in 1976. And it has 1,559 square feet and 0.68 of an acre at Mountain View.
I don't know where Mountain View Circle is.
I don't know either.
Moving on to another East 5th Street house. This one listed for $529. It sold for $515. Through five bedrooms, three baths, 9 days on the market. Built in 1948. With 1,786 square feet on 0.16 and a mountain view. Moving on.
Yes, is now we move to North Jensen.
Yeah.
And this home sold for asking at $545,000. It has three bedrooms, two baths, 2 days on the market, built in 1975, with 1,877 square feet, a little over 1 acre. And they have territorial view.
Okay. And we're coming up to the end of Port Angeles run here. This next one is on 74 Miles Road. I have no idea where that is. Listed for $599,950. It sold for $567,000. Three bedrooms, two baths, 23 days on the market. Built in 1996 with 2,362 square feet. On 4.3 acres and a territorial view.
Okay. So last home in Port Angeles to close this last week is on Snyder. We do know where Snyder is.
There's no internet out there.
Yeah, there's no internet. You're sort of on the edge of the wilderness. And this is sold at $609,000 under asking. Yeah, three bedrooms, two baths, 14 days on the market, built in 2011 with 1,473 square feet. And a little under 5 acres, 4.59, and see remarks. So it has some kind of view. So yeah, this week we've got an even number of homes that closed in Port Angeles, 12, and also 12 in Sequim. Now on to Sequim.
Okay, my turn. This next one is a manufactured home on Fir Crest Drive. Listed for $249, it's ended up selling for $230. Was three bedrooms, two baths, 11 days on the market. Built in 1981 with 1,848 square feet and a territorial view. This one's leased land, it's in a park, so.
Okay.
We don't mention that fee, but it's in the $500 or $600.
Yeah, depending on how nice the park is.
And what they supply.
So next one is on Sunset Place, $299,000 list price and sold for $341,400. And happy sellers there. Two bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 3 days on the market, built in 1976 with 1,398 square feet. Just a little bit under half an acre and neighborhood view.
Okay, now we're on another manufactured home in the Lavender Meadows area. It is on north of Violet Avenue, listed for $399. It sold for $394. Three bedrooms, two baths, 23 days on the market, built in 2022 with 1550 square feet. Leased land, no acreage you have to worry about, and a mountain view.
Okay. Excuse me. Got a frog in my throat today. So next one is on Goldenrod Lane. Originally priced and sold at 460. No, not asking. Yeah, my mistake. Originally priced at 489,900. Sold at 468,000. Two bedrooms, two baths, one half bath. 47 days on the market. built in 2007 with 1,800 square feet, 0.13 of an acre in territorial view.
Are we okay?
I'm just chuckling at my math here. It's kind of par for the course.
Oh, the app.
Yeah, it's, anyway.
Okay, this next one, the math was easy. It was on Garden Lane, listed for $560,000. It sold for $557,000. And Brent correctly marked it as 3,000.
3,000 under asking.
Three bedrooms, two baths, 3 days on the market, built in 2003, with 1,678 square feet on a third of an acre, neighborhood view.
Okay.
Yara.
So.
Jara.
Jabba. Jara the Hut. Okay. Jara Way. Originally priced at $635,000, sold for $575,000. Two bedrooms, two baths, 37 days on the market. 2014 is the build year, and it has 1,411 square feet with 0.32 of an acre, third of an acre, Mountain View.
Okay. We're on the final six. This next one is 680,000. Sorry. I forgot how to do this. On American Eagle Drive. Yes, yeah. That sounds so patriotic. Listed for 680, it sold for 665. Three bedrooms, two baths, 13 days on the market. Built in 2015 with 1718 square feet on 0.23 of an acre. And it says it has a saltwater view. That would be the Point Williams view, in case you were wondering.
Okay, this is, we've not been in this house, but it looks like quite the place. Mm-hmm. So it's on Snowberry Lane, originally priced at $725,000, sold for $2,000 more at $727. Two bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 9 days on the market, built in 1989 with 1,918 square feet. And 2.52 acres, territorial view.
All righty. This next one is on Griffith Farm Road. Originally listed for $759,000, and that is what it sold for. Three bedrooms, two and a half baths, 1993 it was built, with 1924 square feet on 1 1/3 acres and a mountain view.
On to Seahawk Drive.
Should be coming up. We're going to start the season.
Yeah, yeah. Ever since they traded Russell Wilson, I don't know why.
Yeah, Russell Wilson was not good.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. Anyway. Okay,
but
so.
But everybody stopped looking, watching.
Well, not everybody. We did. Well. Because we like Russell. Anyway.
I don't even know who's on it now.
Yeah.
So, where is this one?
And this is up on Seahawk Drive.
Okay.
Okay. Enough of that. Milk on that one. Okay, originally priced at $850,000, sold for $835,000, and three bedrooms, two baths, one half bath, 20 days on the market, built in 1990 with 2,280 square feet, has saltwater and mountain view with 1.16 of an acre.
Okay, the next one. Didn't we do three of them on Ravens Ridge, like recently?
No.
Okay, this next one is on Ravens Ridge Drive Road. Listed for $935,000, it sold for $860,000. Three bedrooms, two and a half baths, 6 days on the market. Built in 1987 with 3,360 square feet and 1 1/4 acre. And it has a saltwater view. Mm. It's on Bell Hill and it has a very nice little view.
Yeah, big place. Okay, bringing it home today, last home in Sequim is on Tyler View Place. originally sold asking and sold at price at $925,000. Two bedrooms, two baths, one half bath. One day on the market, built in 1986, with 2,577 square feet, with 0.87 of an acre, and they have saltwater and mountain view. Whoa.
24 of them we'd
Yeah, there were
barreled.
Times about a year ago we had five. Whole area, five home close.
It's
so,
different out there.
Yeah, it's picking up a little bit. More homes are on the market. And Amy has some stats that she'll run through with you.
Currently, Port Angeles has 89 homes to choose from, of all the prices. Sequim has 174. That's quite a bit. In the last 30 days, there have been 102 homes come on the market in both areas, with 115 of them, or 115 have price changes.
Yeah.
Like just today, five came on, 10 had price reductions. So you can figure that one out. Anyway, we have, that's enough of that.
We're kind of wore out this morning.
Our helper with the turnovers on the vacation rental, she's moved, and so we've had to do some more, and it's exhausting, and laundry. Well, I did 15 sets of sheets.
Yeah, that's our daughter, so she's our cleaner.
Yeah.
But she's been moving this week, which means we've been moving with her, and thank God for Logan's help. Logan used to be a professional mover. He's not been a shaker, but just couldn't. I'm sorry, but used to work for Mountain Moving in Winter Park, Colorado. So, if you're from
if you're from
Winter Park, Colorado, give us a shout.
What's the opening today?
Oh, the opening today.
Brent couldn't find his clear glasses.
Are these dark again?
Oh yeah.
Sorry, I've been swapping them out here. I've got two of these. I put them in the cucumber pouch. There we go. But I'll see if I can find my clear glasses next week. But the opening is Joyce Daze, and it looks like we must have had a wonderful time because we haven't been yet.
Yeah, we're heading there right now.
Yeah, we're going to go up there right now, and so Logan will film that.
And we might leave before the parade at 1.
Yeah, we usually leave, but they have this great salmon lunch. I hope they have it. I usually get it. But everybody is a salmon fisherman out there. So anyway, it's got a little bit longer today. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you have a great week. See you next week.
Cut.